guts, and sheer determination. These are the qualities of a championship team. The 1992 Jacksonville State University Gamecock football squad displayed all of these characteristics and more en route to an improbable, always entertaining, seemingly impossible national championship season. 3 times, Jacksonville State had been to the top of the Division II mountain, only to come away empty-handed. 3 huge disappointments. But the 4th time was a charm. JSU did not have an experienced quarterback until midway through the season when Chuck Robinson, a true sophomore, solidified the Gamecock offense with his leadership. There were major holes to fill in the offensive line, but Brad Dooley, John Ingram, Keith Maple, Matt Hollis, Andre Allen, Banyan Allison, and Scott Peavy gelled as a unit and got the job done in the trenches, paving the way for the JSU ground game. In spite of the loss of several members from a defensive unit that finished 3rd in the nation in scoring defense, the Red Bandits continued the tradition in bone-crunching style. Led by all GSE players Curtis McDaniel, Jacarl Barnett, Eric King, and Carlos Shepard, the Gamecock defenders allowed a few more points and yards, but came up with enough big plays in the clutch to lead the team to a 12-1-1 record. After getting off to a 5-1-1 start and looking a little rough around the edges, the Gamecocks pulled together and belted out 7 straight wins to take the NCAA Division II crown from Pittsburgh State. Postseason accolades included 9 first-team All-Gulf South Conference players, 3rd-team AP All-America honors for kick returner, halfback, punt returner Danny Lee, who was also named Small College Player of the Year by the Alabama Sports Writers Association and the Football Gazette, and GSE and National Coach of the Year honors for head coach Bill Burgess. What began as a dream with the 92 Gamecock football players, Jacksonville State University, and the community of Jacksonville ended with the thrill of a national championship, the thrill of a lifetime.